scratch that. Some of you guys may think that this is a vlog, but it's not a vlog. It's gonna be portion vlog slash unboxing slash gameplay, because I do have to bring you guys some gameplay with this, because I want to try it out and I want you guys to let me know what you think of it. And of course, I'll give you guys my feedback. Before I begin, I just want to thank you guys for supporting the channel. A few years back when I started this channel, I thought it was really cool seeing like my favorite YouTubers unboxing their gaming stuff, right? To think that now I'm doing it for you guys, it's a cool feeling. So thank you guys for supporting the channel, and thank you, Scuf. I'm privileged to be one of the very, very, very few first people to have this product and share with my audience. It looks freaking awesome. Here we go. Yes, the box has already been opened because I could not wait and I opened it. So yeah, we have some nice padding so the packages don't move, but I don't need to tell you guys because that's pretty fucking obvious. So we're gonna remove that. This is a Scuf for another day. Okay, this is something that I've been asking for that, not asking, I've been talking about it, that I, you know what, I'll make a video about it later. So here we have two new Scuffs, okay? One is pretty familiar, and the other one is completely new, okay? And this is the care package, which basically comes with all the essentials or whatnot, thumbsticks, et cetera, gamer grip sometimes. It all depends what you ask for, what they give you. Now with this package also came a letter, which I already read, so Scuff, if you're watching, thank you. I think, I'll decide by the end of the video, by the end of the day. You guys let me know in the comments. I think I'm gonna do a Scuff giveaway. Maybe when I hit 1 million subs, I'll do a Scuff giveaway. If you guys want me to do a Scuff giveaway, let me know in the comments. Drop a like on the video, and I always announce my giveaways on my Twitter, so the link to my Twitter is down in the description. The brand new Scuff Infinity 4 PS Pro. This will be very similar to the one you've seen in the past, the Scuff 4 PS Infinity, which is the one prior to this one. This one just has a little bit of upgrades or whatnot. And then I'm gonna show you the brand new remodeled Scuff Impact. So obviously when you open this one, you have your nice little booklets, instruction stickers, all that cute stuff for those of you guys that like stickers. This is the paddle remapping in the back, trigger extenders, and you also have your hair trigger adjustment tool. The brand new Scuff 4 PS Infinity Pro. What's new here? Really quickly, for those of you guys who don't know, Scuff does have their own joysticks, okay? You can also change these joysticks if you get the Infinity or the Infinity Pro. As I told you earlier, there's a little tool here, and you simply put it in here, you twist, and then you literally can pull this out. It comes out like that, and then you could put it back in. Put your joystick back in there, you make sure it's nice and tight, put the ring, the tool over, and there you go. Obviously, you guys know you can change the joysticks, concave, dome, high, medium, low. I'll show you guys that later on. Moving on to the back, here we have our triggers. Okay, obviously, I put a trigger extender just so you guys can see the difference. This is a trigger extender, and this is the regular trigger. The hair triggers are right here, in which you can adjust it with a tool that it comes with that I showed you on one of the Ziploc bags, and you can adjust it to see how far you want it to stop, primarily for shooter games, Call of Duty or whatnot. You have the military grip. This is a cool, all blacked out military grip. You could get them in different colors, such as green, red, etc. You guys know the deal. Now, this Scuff, as well as the brand new Scuff Impact, can both be played with wired USB or wireless via Bluetooth. Now, the most exciting thing about this Scuff that I really am excited for, the brand new paddles. This is literally what Scuff is known for. Makes you feel like an octopus. Okay, never mind. In the past, some people would break their paddles because they would rage, or they would press them too hard, or maybe like myself, all of my Scuffs are really well like protected. I take care of my stuff. But one Scuff in particular, which was my favorite, Ryan came and he snapped both of them and they broke right here in the middle. Now, what's cool about these is that you can now take them off. This has never been done on a Scuff controller. So simply to take them off, you pull it up a little bit, just a little bit, not to break it. You push up and to the side and they come off. So you do that up and to the side. To put the paddles back, you get the paddle, you come in at an angle, and then you go down. And there you go. If anything were to happen to your paddles, if you purchase one of these Scuffs using code HOLO, because you obviously get that discount, you have 12 months, Scuff will replace your paddles, okay? So you have 12 months to chew on them, break them. I'm just kidding. Don't do that crazy shit, all right? Just calm down. You got 12 months, so you don't really have to worry if anything. I'm not sure what you said there. That was Siri, sorry. Next up, we have the brand new reimagined Scuff Impact. According to Scuff, they've been working on this controller for about 15 months. You got the paddle remapping. So you can change where your paddles configure to, depending on which button you want it to be. Trigger extender, same thing as the other one, basically. Little booklet, instructions on how to do stuff. And here you have the brand new Scuff Impact. It's gonna look a little bit different than the original Scuff controller. Right off the bat, the first thing that I noticed was obviously it's a little bit wider. The reason why they did that was so they can put the four paddles in the back, because PlayStation 4 Scuffs never really had four paddles. There was just no space back there. The rings around the joysticks are a little bit thinner. That's something that I did notice, which is pretty nice. These little edges around here, as you can see right there where the D-pad is, got the same thing around the buttons as well, and it kind of connects to the joysticks. So it's a pretty cool design. Right here, you obviously have the SCUF logo, which is also known as the power button for the controller. Down here, you have what I believe would be for your headphones. Now, if you turn this crazy controller around, you have what literally looks like the most insane freaking controller ever. So finally, we have four paddles on a PlayStation 4 SCUF. You have the military grip, you got the triggers, you can put trigger extenders. Obviously, the four paddles, you can remove these four paddles as well as put them back. Okay. Always make sure they're all the way down. And then here around where the USB cable goes, they have like a little pocket. They're calling this the cable retention system. What it does is once you connect the USB in there, this little pocket serves as kind of like a holster. Like it kind of holds the cable a little bit further out instead of the cable just hanging down. And then obviously getting some wear and tear over the months, so you don't have to be spending money on cables. The paddles, you can remap them with the remapping tool for the paddles. You can put the paddles to be any of your joysticks or buttons. Doesn't really matter what. I believe the controller is 6 millimeters wider, I think, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong. Simply, again, just so they can put the four paddles. As you guys can see, it is really, really cool. This down here reminds me of the Xbox 360 hybrid or the Xbox 360 controller a little bit. Just this part right here. Just because of that little nice curve that it has. And to be honest, it feels really good. I almost forgot to show you guys the care package that comes with the SCUF. I'm gonna show you how the cable pocket works now. So we have a beanie here from SCUF. We got a controller holster. We have some joysticks, some gamer grip, and we got a USB cable. What else do we got in here? And these are some rings. For this controller, you can now put regular PlayStation joysticks. If you don't like regular SCUF joysticks, you can put PlayStation joysticks. Forgot to mention that, very, very important, because a lot of people like these joysticks, but for instance, I don't use these joysticks just because I use Control Freaks. I'm actually very happy that, you know, they made it possible for us to put our PlayStation joysticks in here. Both are good. It's up to you. It's personal preference. All right, so really quickly, I'm gonna get my old cable that I use to charge my controller currently. And basically that's how it would work. So essentially the USB connection starts about right here. So now you have about half an inch just holding the beginning port, right, of the USB. It allows it to hang more straight instead of just kind of go like that. Therefore, obviously, this not wearing and tearing as much. All right, guys, so check it out. I'm in Black Ops 3. I'm gonna run a quick game. I feel a little weird because I'm a little bit more distant from the screen just because I got another camera. Just pointed down at my crotch for no reason. There's a purpose for it. It is the SCUF Impact, as you guys can see right there. I like this little light here, man. I really do. It's pretty cool. Like, the reason they made it actually bigger is simply for the paddles, so they could fit. When you use paddles, you somehow put your fingers differently as opposed to using a controller without a pad. Hopefully I get into a free-for-all lobby. Usually in Black Ops 3, I've had issues. Oh, there we go. Never mind. Okay, I'll take that back. Oh, this is actually my first time ever playing with a controller that has four paddles. This is definitely something that I'm gonna have to get used to, because you already know, your boy gotta get them trick shots, bro. You may see me sometimes use the buttons instead of the triggers, but that's because I'm not used to it. But the first trigger right here, the one on the left, this one right here, is A. Okay, this one is melee. So the ones on the outside are obviously the original A and B, or X and circle. This one is square. The one towards the left middle is square. This one is Y. Swap weapons. Oh my goodness. This is just crazy. This is fucking awesome. Started this lobby a little bit late, but it's okay. It's just to showcase the controller or whatnot. For those of you guys that are watching are probably seeing me shoot and aim with R1 and L1. It's because that's just the way that I do it. I've always done it that way. I've always swapped my PlayStation shooting buttons. And I got killed by the fucking Thunder God of Black Ops 3. Yo, calm down, bro. I got a SCUF fucking Impact. All right. Using the paddles for that melee. What up, though? You know, I'm gonna be quite honest with you guys right now. This controller is out of control. It is so comfortable. Like, I thought four paddles was probably gonna be too much for me, obviously, because I'm not used to it. But I'm also really not too good with, like, big controllers. That's why, like, on the Xbox 360, you know, it takes me a few minutes to get used to it. And that's only because swapping from PS4 to Xbox is kind of like a little bit of a change, right? But now it's like, I have the best of both worlds. This shit's pretty good. Oh my goodness. I'm just gonna obviously have to start training my brain somehow to get used to the fact that I have more than two paddles on the back. Yo, I swear to God, every time I play Black Ops 3, everybody's using the Brecci. Why hasn't Treyarch nerfed that shit? Like, seriously, come on, Treyarch! Look at this. Fucking asshole! Taste the wrath of my paddles! Bitch! Yeah, that was a little bit cheesy. Look at this. Fucking, we got the Brady Bunch up in this shit. Sorry if sometimes the put the controller all the way here. I'm not used to playing like with the controller, you know, clenched up to my stomach. Camping like a noob. Woo! Go, bro. Okay, I'm really liking it. Feels really comfortable. I know when we were in the meeting, they told us it's gonna be really comfortable, and I was like, you know, it probably is. But then when I saw it in person, I was like, it has four paddles. I'm getting nervous. But it's actually pretty good. Dude, I was gonna make the comeback, bro. We started late anyways. Just wanted to show you guys a brand new PlayStation 4 Scuf Impact. It is some dope stuff. There you guys can see it on the bottom camera. Focus on the controller, not on my legs, all right? I know I got some sexy ass legs, but calm down, okay? For those of you guys that have been on the channel for a while, you know I don't make, like, dedicated videos on anything unless it's something that I'm personally sponsored by or that I obviously use. Even then, I don't always do it, but I really do love Scuffs. I have a lot of controllers of Scuff, okay? And all I use is Scuff. And I'm really excited. If you thought the PS4 controller was good, this definitely, it tops it. It's really, really freaking good. I just want to say thank you guys again for allowing me to do this. It's an honor to be able to show this to my subscribers and be one of the first to ever have one of these. It's all possible because of you guys. So please let me know in the comments, what did you guys think about the controller? I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I know it's a little bit different than what I normally do, but I just wanted to share this with you guys. And as always, my name is Hollow, and I'll catch you guys on the next video.